Howdy, everyone. Y'all with me, Voltage. And I'm actually in a new recording place for once. I'm actually back at my regular house where I live at. I'm no longer with the dog, so there should be a lot less barking in the background. So let's do this. And also, this is Bendy versus Baldy. Bendy the Ape Machine versus Baldy B6 Death Arena. This is the fight that I'm actually looking forward to, so let's see what happens. Yahoo! Oh, yeah! 1 second. Let's continue. God. This is better now. Represent numerous things, even including things like cartoons in school. And these two are jump scaring icons for those exact kinds of games. Bendy, the dancing ink demon, and Baldy, the abusive math teacher. Today, we're gonna find out which indie horror icon will claim victory and survive in the Who's a better fighter? A mascot is something nearly every series or company needs. Yep, he owes the mascot. Ask me my Pikachu, Voltage of Pikachu. Mascot for his cartoons. A little demon known to everyone as Her ability's 10? Revolved around Bendy almost. What? If not, all the time. Bendy had started plenty of cartoons, such as Cookie Cookin' and Little Devil Darling. Being so popular, Bendy had many more things made of him. Toys, books, and more. Those actually know. And everyone loved him. Don't play the Bendy games or the Baldy game. Joey Drew had sent a letter to his old pal Henry to come. I've seen people play it, but I don't play myself. But he did, which leads us to the game. Henry had arrived. Nobody. Ink manipulation, jump scares, ink demon creation, regeneration, shapeshifting beast form.
Was around to find, and after he searched everywhere, he found the ink machine and put some stuff near it for reasons nobody can really think of. And eventually, this all leads to Henry finding his way blocked, and our old pal Bendy came up and made Henry flee, but Henry wasn't able to escape in time, leaving him falling down a hole, continuing his journey to escape from his ink hell. Now enough story,
let's continue.
What you all came here for, Bendy's powers. Being an ink monster, he has control over all ink in the area.
Makes sense.
Actually in the studio he is in, making this power even better, to an unclear amount. Given we don't know how the ink machine works, so he could be drawing endless ink from it, making him basically.
If this takes place in Bendy's area, then it's an easy win for him. Walls,
and likely also other solid objects, making slowing him down near impossible. Control over his whole body should make it pretty clear that he can form his body in many different ways, including turning to a puddle, or becoming his demon form, and likely even more things. He seems to never tire, given he is not organic. Thus he can't become exhausted, and he took over the whole studio he was trapped in for over 30 years, which also means he doesn't require normal human needs, such as food, shrink, or nutrients, since a studio likely doesn't have that much food to survive for 30 years. Even in demon form, he can see people, despite his eyes are covered, but this could just be that he has good senses, so he doesn't need sight. He can turn a person with a mere touch.
Equals if this takes place in Bendy's air location, that's a Bendy win easy for him. And if it takes place in this location,
making them obey him, but he could decide to simply overpower a person, as he can do so, and he was strong enough to rip the projector's head off, which is no easy task. But even with all that, if he gets enough ink, he can transform into Beast Bendy, possessing claws, a mouth full of sharp teeth, as well as being even stronger than Demon Bendy, likely possessing the same powers he did before, but becomes much bigger as a result, with massive arms. Don't get too impressed though, as he can be beaten if shown the end reel, and he will die if the ink in him dies out. Also, destroying the ink machine would leave him weak, and this could mean he eventually dies down, with no ink to fuel himself. Plus, his ink can be dried out. Overall, Bendy's abilities over all ink give him plenty of ways to stalk and attack his enemies. While he is able to change his shape and overall power, he can be destroyed by watching the final tape or being dried up.
Baldy will watch final tape.
Not other subjects like science, English, or history. While entering in here school.
Yeah, because his strength is very low, his speed, however, is pretty good. His durability is very low, his power is very low. Intelligence? He's a smart person. Skill and agility, and no. He's got two good stats.
Speed and intelligent.
He loves math so much that he thinks everyone else should also love math. Unfortunately for everyone, Baldi seems to think loving math and being good at math are the same thing. He'll get angry if you get the question wrong.
Yeah.
And chase you down with a ruler.
And try to slap your ass.
Problem for each notebooks you get with that iPad.
Abilities: math expert, teleportation, flogging, enhanced hearing, jump scares, and bear trap. He uses bear traps? What?
Baldi has the incredible hearing abilities. He can not only tell where any sound came from, but who made it to. He can be slow, but he can be quicker if you answer the math problem incorrectly. After getting sixth notebook, he will become a speed demon. Fortunately, he is distorted by loud noises and make him forget what he was doing. He is easily affected by things like sodas. Baldi also can take the player to field trip in the camping forest. Baldi leaves bear traps in there and Baldi can tell the player to keep the fire going. But if you failed, he will move faster and it is almost impossible to escape him. That's like having nightmare being chased by somebody. Baldi's shorter slap interval is one smack every second, and the intervals get shorter by 0.25 seconds for every answer you get wrong. When it comes to durability, Baldi can survive getting swept by Goddess Sweep, who is strong enough to smash through locked doors. Baldi can be abusive no matter how many questions you get wrong, with no excuses or anything. Run while you still can. Overall, Baldi may be human, but his enhanced hearing makes it practically impossible to escape his wrath. He is skilled with his ruler, very tough, and knows no mercy.
Yeah, but still, even with no mercy, location, school, and studio, bold. Ooh, this is not good for Baldi. This is Bendy's win, I think. Flip a clip, canister. What's the international travel for Baldi? Seriously?
The fuck is that?
Or Bendy's international travel, okay? Equals he's got no ink left to have for his powers, okay? Yeah, I still think Bendy wins it. Hi, and welcome to my schoolhouse. What did I just called it? He's not aggressive. Okay. Four. He is very bad at math.
You stupid.
He is very, very bad at math. You're punching teachers in the hall. Punch him in the back and slap him with a ruler? What do you think that was gonna do, huh?
Oh, what
the Principal Thing's dead. So is he. It's a bully who's dead. Dude, just give up. You can't win this fight. Yeah. What did I say?
Bendy plus Baldy equals death. I really don't know what you expected. I could end this debate with one word. And that word is durability.
Yes.
Bendy is a demon made completely out of ink. His body can always just regenerate, as long as there is ink around.
Yes.
True, Baldy can brush off being smashed through locked doors, but that's child's play compared to what Bendy can do. Bendy had the edge in pretty much every category. The only thing Baldy might have over Bendy is intelligence. But Bendy is quite smart himself, so that wouldn't even be that big of an advantage.
Yeah.
Finally, Bendy could only be defeated if you show him the ending tape, dry him out, or destroy the ink machine. Baldy doesn't have the knowledge or power to do any of that. Guess Baldy didn't think this through. The winner is Bendy.
Want to see a horror game free-for-all with likes of Freddy Fazbear, Bendy, Baldy, SCP-123 and more? Like this video if this video gets 50 likes, it'll be a free-for-all. I actually think someone's already done this, buddy, before. Ahem, Cartoon Fight Club's already done this kind of thing before. They're already did a free-for-all like this. SCP-682 won that fight. Because it's SCP-682, because he's a god, apparently. But also, a little notice. I watched your Charmander vs. Spike video a while back. And I want you to make a match Charmander can actually win, which is actually fair for him. The animation literally had Charmander get murdered. He's a Pokemon. Pokemon are not supposed to get murdered. Give him a better chance in a fight, please, for Charmander. Do him some justice for my little dude. He's my favorite Pokemon. I can watch him get ripped apart. A while ago, Pinkie Pie revealed that our series was taking a break from My Little Pony and Puppet Toy Master Desk. Break is almost over. But we're going to end that break with a special battle. You guys voted, and it's time to reveal our most requested and final match of the break. I'm not going to really watch the Paw Patrol or My Little Pony ones, unfortunately. Who's next, huh? Two Disney icons, of course, Disney. Sora? Oh, Magical Girls, never mind, I know it's not Sora. I've got no clue who the hell these two people are. So I won't be watching this matchup then. Well, I will watch it, but not reacting to it. I don't care about who these two are at all. I'll still see the video, but don't care who wins the matchup. Annie versus Luz. Yeah, I don't really care who wins that fight. But anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. And try to make a match for Charmander to win, please. Bye!